Welcome, and thanks for listening to my presentation about a calculator that we at BASF have developed to measure the impact of different farming practices on biodiversity. My name is Kerstin Ulrich, and within the Global Sustainability Team at BASF Agricultural Solutions, I am responsible for our life cycle assessment tool called AgBalance. Before I now go into the details of the calculator, let me say a few words about AgBalance. We at BASF have developed this tool already around 10 years ago, and we are using it actively since 2012 to calculate the sustainability performance of different farming practices over all three sustainability pillars. We are taking into account the environmental performance, but also economic considerations and even social contributions to enable farmers to measure, demonstrate, and improve their sustainability performance. Because as always, you can best improve what you can measure. The environmental part of AgBalance is derived from the product environmental footprint, the PEF, from the European Commission. So that brings me back to the topic of this presentation, as PEF does not provide any method on how to assess the impact on biodiversity. And of course, biodiversity is a very important impact to assess when it comes to sustainable agriculture. In many reports, agriculture has been described as putting a lot of pressure on biodiversity, but also biodiversity as being crucial in order to sustain a healthy soil and sustaining yield. We at BASF see biodiversity as the backbone of agriculture. So, how best to improve biodiversity in agriculture? It comes back to what I said earlier, that you can best improve what you can measure. And this is why we developed the tool I will now present to include the biodiversity measurement into AgBalance. So, what did we do? First, we had to define our point zero, so the number of potential species at risk if no biodiversity measures are applied. For that, we took the characterization factors provided by Chaudhary et al. In his publication, Chaudhary derives values for the potential loss of species due to land occupation and land transformation for in total 804 ecoregions, as well as 245 countries and islands. The numbers are provided for 5 taxa in 3 land use types, and all for the intensity levels, minimal to intense use. With these numbers, we defined our y-axis by taking the numbers for what Chaudhary defines as intense use and as minimal use, and by interpolating between the two, we derived a score between 0 and 100%. The gradient of the line differs from ecoregions to ecoregion and from country to country, depending on the numbers provided by Chaudhary. So then, we needed to define what would change the position of the dot reflecting the potential of species loss if biodiversity measures are applied. In the case of this graph, the x-axis. For that, we had a look at the interventions provided by conservation evidence. This is a free access database listing 1,734 biodiversity measures in 15 categories. All interventions are based on scientific literature and classified by an expert panel according to their effectiveness and the quality of the evidence available for the intervention, in the database listed as certainty. For our calculator, we concentrated on 2 categories, the farmland conservation and the Mediterranean farmland, and we extracted 29 interventions after we removed redundancies. From the scores for the certainty and effectiveness provided by conservation evidence for one of the measures, we derived a single action score that we then scaled as a quotient of the sum of all the action scores that we chose to again achieve a score between 0 and 100% for each of the measures of the x-axis. In the calculator, all single action scores of the biodiversity measures that are implemented are added up, and this defines the position of the dot on the x-axis. And now, I would like to show you a glimpse of what the interface of our calculator looks like. First of all, you see a starting page where you can already choose some parameters, but as they can always be changed, I will now click on Start. On the left side, you see the option to do the assessment according to country or ecoregion. Here, all the 245 countries and islands, as well as the 804 ecoregions I already mentioned, are listed. And as I said, the gradient will change depending which country or ecoregion is chosen. So this would be the Sahara Desert. It has a different gradient than, for instance, Germany. In the next part, the land use type, cropland, pasture, or plantation forest is defined. Then the user can choose either all interventions to be shown or only those that are on or off crop. And the user can exclude those interventions that would require the reduction of cultivated area. Furthermore, the user can exclude those interventions that would require a change of input data, like for instance, the reduction of fertilizers, pesticides, and/or herbicides. Further down, according to the choices above, the list of possible intervention appears, and the user can tick those that are relevant for the current study. Next to the intervention, one gets the action score that was assigned to the intervention according to calculation we did based on conservation evidence, and that will add up to the value on the x-axis for our dot. Ticking all measures will get the dot up to 100% and thereby document a minimal potential to lose species. The potential will never be zero, but by applying biodiversity measures, the potential can be significantly reduced. For the SCA, the values are shown here below as characterization factors for land occupation and land transformation. These values are then used in AgBalance to provide the numbers for the biodiversity impact category. With this tool, we have developed a calculator that allows the integration of a biodiversity category in agricultural LCA. That can also be used standalone to give farmers an idea which of the measures might provide the biggest contribution to biodiversity protection. It is a global tool that still can and will be improved. For instance, it is missing a module for perennials. Also, conservation evidence is very focused on Europe and therefore needs adjustments to cover the other regions in the same accuracy. We are planning to set up long-term experiments to enhance biodiversity in agriculture. Our biodiversity calculator will accompany these experiments to be able to compare the results of the calculator with primary data. This will then hopefully enable us to derive a real interrelation with the other impact categories in order to develop an endpoint-oriented damage category. Still, we are very happy with the progress we've made and the tool we've created. So we are looking forward to applying the tool in practice. With this, I invite you to read the paper where you can get even more details about our calculator. If you have questions around AgBalance or if you have recommendations on how we can improve the tool, please do not hesitate to contact me at agbalance@bsf.com. Last but not least, I would like to give a special thanks to Patricia Granados and Markus Frank for their scientific support in the development of this tool and their energy. And I thank you for listening to my presentation to the very end.